belly as their gut changes from milk from their mother into the pellets, and they go through these weird stages. So he's a little putty that drags down some of their depth here through the midsection. And you can even see as he's breathing, you can see this hollowness right here. So it's very unfair for me to say that he fails today in depth. I need to see him about another month or two to see how he fills in over the top. He does have a good lower hind quarter. He's very broken in coat. He's in between coats right now, spoiling some of his uniformity and density and texture. Again, I'd have to see him in another couple months to really be able to give a fair evaluation. He might be a bit heavy in his pattern, but as he matures, he's going to get bigger and his pattern will open up more. So he's a very promising dog.
Not yet.
I don't
know. When you raise Rex, you need to have Kathy come here. Kathy is amazing. She's taught me so much about
horses. I see. Okay, I see.
Also, we have line of Kathy
in here. Kathy has amazing. The same thing with Dawn and a bit on the thin side as well. Nice pattern.
Thank you.
today just a little bit as far as texture of coat, but it's an age issue. I have a feeling that either the other dough is a little bit more mature, or you've gotten, maybe just had a little bit better time growing up in this dough. Both wonderful body type. She's just a little grainier in her texture, a little bit more drag in our first place, but good color, both domestic show quality young animals. Really appreciate the opportunity. Today, our best breed and best opposite are going to be our otters.
Okay!
Yeah, the caster is almost like its own breed. A broken caster has good color. It has good color. This broken? If the broken caster has good color, you can read into the caster. And see, you'll notice that people who breed broken casters over broken blacks, they're broken casters, they breed into the casters. If you breed your broken casters to your broken blacks, your color gets muddy, like that buck. And I'm not here to speak ill of anybody's animals, but like that buck, he's gonna produce a whole bunch of rabbits with muddy color. And it's one of those things, once you have good color, you keep it. But once you introduce something and darken the lines or lessen the color, it's so hard to get back. So, and even your casters, if you have good color casters, you can breed them with otters. I mean, that's a compatible thing. If you have good color, it'll brighten the otter factor of your otters. Thank you.